Hi guys, in this Simulink screencast, I'm going to discuss about DPSK modulation and demodulation, that is differential phase shift keying modulation and demodulation. The difference between ordinary PSK or BPSK, what you have studied in hardware experiments, and this one is, it does not require a carrier signal at the receiver with the same frequency. That is, at the demodulator end, we don't require a sine wave with this same configuration or the frequency. Okay, we can see here the amplitude is 1, sample per period is 50. So from this, what we can say is this DPSK involves non-coherent detection. That is the main advantage over PSK or BPSK. Okay, now we'll start with our blocks. First one is Bernoulli's binary generator. It is used here to generate digital data sequence. You can see probability of 0 is 0.5, that means zeros and ones are in equal number. Initial seed I have kept 100, sample time minus 1, and here the signal length is 30. Okay, this is very important because if you keep this 10, the signal length will be only 10 and very small amount of signal will be generated. This signal will be 10, means only this much you can visualize. Okay, now we can see the next block is XNOR gate with a unit delay, which is actually used for differential encoding. That means the binary signal is XNOR'd with the output of XNOR gate delayed by one unit, and the signal thus generated is given to modulator. This we can call as modulator, this block can call as modulator, where sine wave is the carrier signal and this switch acts as a product modulator. If one is there, it is transmitting one phase. If zero is there, it will be transmitting another phase. Okay, let us see these blocks. This sine wave is having 5 volt amplitude, 2 pi into 2 frequency radian per second, sample time is 0.01, and this is a product modulator. It is used to generate minus of the sine wave, that is 180 degree phase shift, and this switch is having a threshold value of 0.5 and sample time minus 1. Here U2 is greater than threshold, that means if the signal over here, that is the differential encoded signal here, if it is greater than 0.5, it will transmit one phase of the signal. If it is less than 0.5, it will transmit another phase of the signal. Thus we can visualize the signal now. Yes, you can see here, this is, with this waveform we can easily identify if there is 1 to 0, 0 to 1 changeover in the data sequence. We can observe that there is a phase shift of 180 degree, correct? There is a phase shift of 180 here as well. You can see if continuous ones are there or continuous zeros are there, there is no phase shift. Here there are two phase shifts because 1 to 0, 0 to 1, and here no phase shift continuous ones, which is nothing but our looks like BPSK, phase shift keying, correct? But when we compare this same waveform with the actual input signal, what we are going to get is, yes, now we can see here, there are two zeros in this interval. So we are going to have two phase shifts. That means zeros are conveyed by 180 degree phase shift and ones are conveyed by adding 0 degree phase shift. That is what the importance of this DPSK modulator. Okay. Now this is, we have seen the modulated signal and the message signal. Actually, our message signal is this one, and this is differential data. For this differential data, if we do BPSK, it will look like DPSK. Okay. Now the next step is, this signal can be transmitted, this signal can be transmitted, and at the receiver end we have a demodulator block. This is our demodulator block, along with the same XNOR operation we are going to do at the receiver end also. XNOR operation we are going to do at the receiver end also. So we are going to get back our original transmitted signal. You can see here, this is our signal, and this signal is same as the transmitted data, but it is delayed by, we can say, 1 bit. It is delayed by 1 bit. Okay. I hope you have enjoyed this screencast. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel. Thank you.